them warm. Mix the babbitt a little bit so it doesn't stratify. There's an aluminum bar right there, Fritz. It makes this fixture easier to get out. That just preheats the block. There's two schools of whether you need to preheat it or you pour it cold. So we'll let that set for a few minutes. Melt the old babbitt out. Preheat the rod cap, tin it a little bit if it needs it. This is tinning flux. Thank you. see if we did any good.
Wow.
Even kind of centered. Sometimes it takes a while. Middle didn't have thrust on them, so there. Now we have to pour the rear with a little bit of thrust on it. To keep it between 700 and 800. Degrees. It gets much over 800, 900 degrees, and it starts cooking off all of the good stuff. The tin starts cooking off. antimony. Not too bad.
Where do you get the material for the bearings? Is it like
wheel
weights or?
No. This is comes from Carter Alloys. Place back in Pennsylvania. And you know, we order it. What I did, I knew I took it somewhere. It's really close, within a percent or two of what Ford used in terms of percent of tin in it, tin and copper, a little bit of antimony. It's like 88% tin, no lead.
No lead?
No lead. That's the main difference in the Babbitt. You have tin-based Babbitts and you have lead-based Babbitts. The tin, of course, is what makes it hard. Tin and copper.
Yeah.
A little bit of antimony, but mostly the tin and the copper. Where the lead is soft.
I just assumed there was always lead.
No. That's where you run into some problems when you know, either they didn't have the tin, Red.